In these examples, we want to evaluate the following trig expressions involving trig functions and inverse trig functions. Remember, an inverse trig function returns an angle. So inverse sine 2/5 returns an angle theta, and then we want to take the sine of that angle. So this expression tells us that there's an angle that has a sine function value of 2/5, and we want the sine of that angle. Well, inverse sine is telling us the sine function value, therefore this is just equal to 2/5. Another way to think of it is that the sine function and the inverse sine function, they undo each other, and we're left with 2/5. And yet another way to understand what's happening here, again, the inverse sine of 2/5 returns an angle on the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2 with the sine function value of 2/5. Because the sine function is positive, we'd have a reference triangle in the first quadrant where the opposite side would be 2 and the hypotenuse would be 5. So here's our angle theta, and then the outer function is asking us what is the sine of theta. Well, of course, the sine of theta is 2/5. The second expression is almost exactly the same. If we start with the innermost expression, inverse cosine negative 2/7, this tells us there's an angle theta that has a cosine function value of negative 2/7, and the outer function asks us to determine the cosine function value of this angle, which again is going to be negative 2/7 based upon what inverse cosine tells us. Now this last example is a little bit more involved, so we need to be careful with this one. Starting with the innermost function, inverse cosine 2/3 means there's an angle theta on the closed interval from 0 to pi that has a cosine function value of 2/3. Since the cosine function value is positive, that means our reference triangle would have to be in the first quadrant. So let's go ahead and sketch our reference triangle. It doesn't have to be to scale. So if this is our angle theta, then the adjacent side would have a length of 2, and the hypotenuse would have a length of 3. So this is our angle theta given by inverse cosine 2/3. And now the outer function is asking us for the tangent function value of this angle. We know tangent theta is equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. So for this problem, we do have to determine the length of this side of the triangle. And we can do that using the Pythagorean theorem. Y squared plus 2 squared must equal 3 squared. So y squared plus 4 must equal 9. So y squared equals 5. If we square root both sides of the equation, we know the y value must be positive. So we have y equals square root 5. So now that we've modeled angle theta, we can now determine the tangent of angle theta, which is going to be the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. So we have square root 5 divided by 2. We'll take a look at more problems like this in the next video.